Hello everyone, welcome to my new lecture. In this lecture, we'll study about power quality responsibility. We know that power quality is collective responsibility of the supplier as well as of the end user. So let us start understanding responsibility of the suppliers. The very important is voltage range. We know that plus minus 5% of the nominal voltage that is allowed, because most electrical equipment is designed to operate within a voltage of plus minus 5% of nominal voltage with marginal decrease in performance. The overall effect of voltage excursion outside the nominals are not that significant unless the voltage approach the limit of plus minus 10% of the nominal. Then we have frequency range, that is a plus minus 0.1 hertz of nominal frequency. And normally in urban areas, we have always a frequency range within a nominal frequency range. We have certain switching operation at the substation to adjust the load condition, and then because of this switching operation we have transient generated, and that transients are propagated in the power lines, and this transient can generate disturbance at levels that will have an impact on electrical equipment. Equipment may fail because of this, it is possible. Then we have power quality responsibility from the consumer end. Energy conservation, that is one of the very important concept, and consumer must learn to optimize the energy. Then harmonic current injection. Because of load condition, we have now number of electronics load, and because of load condition, harmonics are generated, and this are injected in the power lines. Up to certain limit, current, harmonic current injection is allowed, but beyond that it must be restricted. Power factor is again one of the very important factor which can be restricted from the consumer end. And surge current demands. If power suppliers and users each do their part, power quality is improved and power consumption is optimized. Now we study a susceptibility criteria. We know that we have two contours as shown in the figure. We have equipment immunity contour and power quality contour, right? If equipment immunity contour is smaller then power quality contour, then there is always a chance of failure or some other problem in the equipment. But if immunity contour is greater than power quality contour, then it can be an immune equipment, and power quality will not affect the performance of the equipment. All devices are susceptible to power quality. No device are 100% immune. All electrical power system installation have power quality anomalies to some degree, and no power system exists for which power quality problems are non-existent. Power quality and equipment immunity are two forces working in opposition. So we have power quality and equipment immunity, both are different force. The object is then to create a balance between the two. By matching the immunity index of a piece of equipment with the power quality index, we can arrive at a balance where all equipment in power system can coexist and function adequately. Okay, now immunity and power quality indices. We have equipment immunity indices. We have index, that is first, second and third. And accordingly, we have high immunity, moderate immunity or low immunity. And we have certain examples for high immunity like motors, transformers, incandescent lighting, heating load, electromechanical relays. For moderate immunity, we have electronic ballast, solid state relays, programmable logic controllers, adjustable speed drives. As well, for the low immunity, we have signal, communication and data processing equipment, as well electronic medical equipment. Similar way, we have power quality indices. Again, we have index 1, 2nd and 3rd. We have low power quality problems. An example, that is service entrance, switchboard, lighting power distribution panel. Second index, that is moderate power quality problems. So that is HVAC power panels. And at index 3, we have high power quality problems. Then example for high power quality problems, that is panel supplying adjustable speed drives, elevators, large motors. The objective of any power quality study or solution is to ensure that the immunity contour is outside the boundaries of the power quality contour. Two methods for solving a power quality problems are to either make a power quality contour smaller so that it falls within the immunity contour, or make the immunity contour larger than the power quality contours. So thank you very much for watching my video. Keep watching. Thank you very much.